Hello and welcome to another edition of Get to Know Providence. Today I'm joined by one of our counseling department members, Jaimie McRae.
Hi, how's it going?
Going well. How are you?
I'm doing just fine.
Got a beautiful backyard there. It's a nice day.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, nice tree in bloom. Yeah, absolutely. Nice day to sit outside.
So, Ms. McRae, you're a member of our counseling department. Tell us how many years you've been at Providence.
This is my 15th year at Providence and my fourth year as the director of school counseling at Providence. I overview the office, but specific grades that I have are going to be 9 and 10. So I will be the freshman counselor for any incoming Providence student.
And then tell us about the other members of the counseling department.
Okay, so in our department, we have Emily Losey, who is the college counselor, and she also has the juniors. And so she does a lot of the same things that I do, but she also now is in charge of a very important element of life, which is the college scholarships and college planning at the very higher level for students. And then also in our department, very instrumental is Amy Delaney, and she is our guidance assistant. We couldn't live without her. She does so many things for us. And also in our department is the campus minister. She is housed there. So we work closely with her too. We're all in the same office. It's very tight, nice group there. And if you get to see Providence, you'll notice that the guidance office really is a nice area for students to utilize.
Yeah, it got remodeled a few years ago, and it's so inviting and welcoming for students. Talk us through and explain some of the different things that a student might go. Let's talk freshmen and sophomores first, whether it's academics or personal issue. There's kind of a large umbrella of things that a student may need to come see you for.
Yeah, the great thing about my job is that, and this is just meets my personality, it probably isn't everybody's personality, is that there's something different every day in the guidance office. And so students utilize our resources for a lot of different things. Initially, every student will meet with their counselor about their schedule. So it's a very simple, simple thing initially is to get a schedule the way the student wants the schedule, or if there are changes in levels that the student wants or in electives, that would be a reason why a student would come into our office. We also work with students on personal matters, anything socially or life events that they might be experiencing. That also may include sometimes with social, some group counseling, depending on the issue. We would work with academic counseling. So a lot of times if a student would need a tutor, we can sometimes be that first connection and help them, whether it's a peer tutor that's an older student, or even if it's further help to utilize maybe the learning resource. And I probably should have mentioned Karen Schuler. She's not in our office, but she is the learning support coordinator, and she does work with us a lot, and she's right across the hall. And that is also another great office that we use, but that is for learning differences and sometimes extra academic help as needed. Really the great thing about being in counseling is that I do get to work with almost everybody in the building in some way at some time. And so many great people at Providence. And so I feel very fortunate that even though I'm in my department with working with really great people in my own department, I also work with teachers and brainstorm with them on how to help students, and I get to work with administration and Karen Schuler and all the learning differences women in there. So it really is an interesting, unique position. Feel very fortunate to have it.
We talked about how, the services you might provide a freshman or sophomore. Let's go back a year now and talk about an eighth grader. We just had a freshman, freshman registration back in February, but for a seventh grader, maybe wondering how that's going to look next year. How do we go about placing students, and talk about the placement exam? I know you are the proctor of that, and talk about how the placement exam then is used to decide what classes students take that first year at Providence?
Well, okay, the placement exam is sort of an initial snapshot. Also, it allows us to know, you know, the student is very serious about coming. When we see that exam, we can kind of determine the student's strength areas and meet with the family and sort of place the family in classes or the student in classes that they will be successful in. At that point, after meeting with parents and the student, and that usually is registration, we can the student can then appeal if they want to and go further. And sometimes there's further testing that we can do that's unique within a department, like math department, and they can sort of give another test that will say this student actually should be in honors geometry or in an honors algebra class. So that is sort of the way the process works. My role in that is definitely I'm the first point of contact for parents. So if a parent has a question about anything that happened with the placement test or they're concerned or just any further question about where their student should be placed, it typically will come to me and then I will help make arrangements to have that student either take a test or to figure out what we can do to help the student with their placement. And then up until, you know, the start of school, we have students who'll change their mind about electives. Maybe they want something different, or they'll maybe decide that they want to do a Spanish 2 instead of a Spanish 1, and that's what their eighth grade teacher had talked to them about. So those are really the first initial ways that I start working with the incoming ninth grade, would be those types of questions and situations. Also, a lot of times parents will call me if they have a specific concern, anything that might have happened in the last year or, you know, a stressor for the student, or even if it might be something that was a physical injury the student had that they're going to need some extra support. So those are all ways that parents would reach out to me, you know, to make sure that we have, you know, the best ready for the student when they come in.
And you know, there's so many amazing things about Providence, and I think the kind of two factors kind of colliding, one being the Christian love that we have for every one of our students as a Catholic school, but then also our small environment really lends itself to be able to treat each student individually, and whether that's academically, mentally, emotionally, or socially, finding ways that to reach that student so that they can reach their full potential. And I know that's at the utmost importance for you and your department.
Yes, definitely. It's an incredible advantage in a smaller school. We can really do a lot of things that are very specific to the needs of the student and, you know, work on a very individual basis with our resources. And that's where all the people that we, you know, that we mentioned in our department can come in. And definitely learning support can come in too, but we also work closely, you know, with the front office too. So there, you know, everyone's aware of a situation that is needed to help the student.
Mm-hmm. Now, even though Mrs. Losey deals mostly with juniors and seniors, I know, you know, you being the head of the counseling department and you've worked with that group of students before and you know what goes on there. So take us through kind of the job that Miss Losey does. And I know she does a tremendous job working with our juniors and seniors, and really maybe talk specifically about that college placement, helping apply for scholarships, all the things in that go into that realm.
Yes. Well, mostly junior year, I would say it's definitely kind of an overview of what the, you know, at the beginning of junior year, what the next 2 years are going to look like. Definitely a lot of specific information. She actually has an entire folder that she gives out to juniors. A lot of it at that point is preparation for the testing that goes on. Most of the time it's junior year, sometimes it's earlier, and that's either an ACT or an SAT. And so a lot of information there concerning the timeline and what is going to need to be done and what's coming. And then definitely by the end of junior year, they are starting to prepare. They've already been preparing, but they're doing things like they have a brag sheet that they will do that is all the things that they've done while they've been at Providence. It's a resume type of activity, and they'll utilize that to hand to someone that they may ask to write them a recommendation. So that's mostly what it's used for, but it's also used when they get to scholarships, that it's something they could quickly go back and look at to remind themselves of the things that they have done. And then really the whole process with a college application starts as soon as they get back to school. And she is in with the seniors, I think the first week of school, and going over again, here's the timeline again of what you need to be doing. And November 1st is the first very important date. And so there's a lot of work that's done between the start of school, November 1st. And the one thing that I know that she does, that's a very personal, personal connection with each student, and that a lot of counselors cannot do because of the size of the school, is that she does write a letter of recommendation for every student, every senior, on their common application. It's not always necessary. Sometimes it's optional, but she does write one for every single student that is applying, especially on that common app. And there's even further that she'll do for some of the specific colleges and universities if they're not using Common App, or if the student is doing just that in that application for that university.
Wow. You know, so that just goes so far to, you know, the personal attention that you give the students as they come into Providence, making sure that they have that that guidance, and they're put in the right place that they're going to be able to achieve and succeed academically. And then Emily really kind of transitioned them off to college. Mrs. Losey doing such a wonderful job there, making sure that they're prepared to go on to that next level of life. And, you know, at Providence, we are been so fortunate that, you know, every year we have 98-99% college placement, and our students are awarded tens of millions of dollars in scholarship money to college. And I believe that that is a testament to three things. Number one, the upbringing and the parents and the family guidance that they have. Two, maybe most importantly, is the inner drive that the students have to want to be successful. But I don't think we can downplay enough the role that Providence, the administration, the teachers, and the guidance office has in that.
Well, it always is a very motivated student body. They want to do well. I think they also push each other, which isn't always the case when you're in a senior class in some other places. You know, these are students who are very motivated, and it's great to work with them because they are motivated and they do achieve. And I think it's the whole atmosphere, and it's everyone, it's the parents and the students, you know, with each other, and then everybody in the building who's wanting them to be successful too.
Absolutely. Well, Mrs. McRae, thank you so much for taking some time to speak with us. And really, thank you so much for the work that you do with our students. Sometimes it's done behind the scenes where nobody knows what's going on, but the student that you're working with and their families, they certainly know. And so thank you for that.
Thank you, Brad. I appreciate being interviewed.
Have a great day.
You too.